guys, welcome back to Olivia's Grad Life, well, now called Olivia's Grad School Vlogs, where I share with you my insight as a media psychology graduate student at Penn State. So I did just finish my first semester as a master's student, and I learned quite a few things. There are things that are like, it's sort of what I wish I would have known, but at the same time, it's like, I'm really glad that I learned it my first semester so I can take this with me moving forward in my graduate career. So I have a bulleted list of 6 things to tell you today, what I wish I would have known before starting grad school. I also have this Pinch Me box back here if you're interested in how to get samples sent to you for free in exchange for your honest opinion about them. Click on the link in the description box below. I also just made a video about this on my other channel, so that's why this is here. Anyway, point one. Get a citation software. I don't know what your graduate program is in, but mine is social sciences, and that means we write a lot of papers. So what a citation software does, such as EndNote, Mendeley, or Zotero, is it's a way for you to export the citation as well as export a PDF of the article you're trying to cite, save it in this library and database, and then whenever you're writing a paper, you hit insert citation, click on the article, and it does perfect APA format for you, both in-text citation and then starts your reference list at the bottom of the paper. So it's a really, really big time saver, as well as just a really great way to kind of start your database. After this semester, I have already had over 100 articles in that. So imagine those 100 articles just being kind of like willy-nilly scattered across, saved in different folders on my laptop, whereas with this, it's all in one place. All of the information, the page number, the journal, when it was published, the DOI, all of it is saved. So whenever I need to reference it, it's right there. Simple click makes a reference. Now, EndNote versus the other two, EndNote you do have to pay money for. There is a student version. I think it costs about $100 or so. But what's cool about EndNote is you can share libraries with other researchers. So let's say you're collaborating with someone on a topic, your specialty is media, social media stuff, their specialty is health communication, but you're working together on this project. You can share libraries for a certain amount of time, and so that way you have access to their health communication stuff, they have access to your social media library, and you yourself aren't having to go through and find all of those health communications articles. Zotero is free. That's what a lot of people that I know use as well. They either use EndNote or Zotero. So again, it's the same thing. I just don't think with Zotero you can share libraries. But if you're an undergrad watching this, or if you don't really think you're gonna go on and do a PhD, just a master's program, maybe Zotero is what's gonna be good enough for your needs. The second thing I wish I would have known was when downloading PDFs and articles from the library, from Google Scholar, I did not save it as the title of the paper. I saved it as Photoshop article, yay, Drew's Fitspiration article. Like, I was just kind of making up names for like what the topic of it was, but that caused so much problems later, because when I was going through trying to find, okay, I know this author said this, but man, I cannot find that article. I was having to click through the 30 different articles I had saved on Fitspiration to find what I was looking for. So now what I do is I get the article pulled up online, I control C the title, then I save as a PDF, control V, I have pasted the title. So even if it's only like half of the title, it'll be easy to find it. Do that, and don't waste your time making up article names. I know that sounds so simple, but like, that is something that I learned this semester. Side note, in EndNote and Zotero, you can also save the PDF of the article. So you can just export the citation, but what I also really recommend is attaching that PDF. So you will still have it saved on your computer somewhere, but this way you also have it attached to the citation. So again, just makes your life a lot easier. The third really important, really cool thing that I learned how to do this semester is called an annotated bibliography. So we all know what a bibliography is. It's your works cited, it's your reference list, it's the articles that you used and referenced during the article, right? But while you're actually writing it over the course of the semester or however long, an annotated bibliography is so helpful. Basically, you have your reference, and then under it, you yourself write a paragraph to half a page of how that article relates to your paper. So you can talk about the main points. For some of mine, It was literally just measurements and scales that they used. For other ones, it was their specific findings. Other articles, I mentioned, oh, this uses self-compassion as a moderator, as well as XYZ. So it doesn't have to be like an abstract of the article. It's what is relevant about this article to you. Because when you're starting working on this in September, and then it comes to December 10th and you're trying to write your final paper, it's gonna be really hard to remember what exactly certain things said. Especially once you get to like publishing, you send it out for peer review, it can take like 3 months minimum for it to come back. By that point, you've probably started working on other projects, you might not remember every detail about the paper, and so having an annotated bibliography, really good way to keep you on track. Fourth thing I have learned is outlining in PowerPoint is actually a really good way to go. Sometimes I'm an outliner, sometimes I'm not, but one thing that I found really helped me this semester was actually during finals week. Our last class of the semester, we had to give PowerPoint presentations of our paper, and then the next week is when our paper was actually due. And so by organizing it in a PowerPoint presentation, that actually helped me so much realize how I wanted to configure my paper, how I wanted to organize it. And when I mentioned this to other PhD students, they were like, yeah, that's always how we organize our papers. Alrighty, my family just got home, we ate, they're back out again. So anyway, PowerPoint, really good way to organize an outline. I remember my senior year of college at Davis in my writing class, our professor had us write an outline for our final paper, and then she actually handed us scissors and told us to cut every single line, like mix it up, and then arrange our paper. And it was really amazing to see when all of that stuff is very flexible, like you can physically just like and move it to another place. It helped organize it better. It helped you to actually physically see that a point might fit better over here rather than where it was. I feel like PowerPoint is similar, especially if you use different slides. It's very easy to move slides up and down and rearrange how they are. So PowerPoint, really good way to outline. It can also be a good way if you're making different figures, like flowcharts, that you're gonna then put in your paper. PowerPoint is just sometimes easier to work with, so keep that in mind. The fifth and final really important thing I learned this last semester was to not get caught up on the small details and to realize that sometimes good enough is what it's going to have to be. So let me explain that a little bit further. I was writing my final papers, and basically what I had to do was come up with a study, do like the introduction, the lit review, methods, for one of them just methods, for the other one you also do the results and the discussion, like with fake data. And I kept getting caught up on like the tiniest little things about how I was gonna operationalize, not even operationalize certain variables, like what my stimulus was exactly going to be. None of the rest of the paper was done, but I was making sure that this picture that I wanted to use was better than this other picture. Okay, all of that stuff, the little details about the exact experiment, you're gonna refine those like once you actually do the experiment, like when you're talking with your advisor about it. So what I learned was to not get caught up on those really small details, on those really small things that like don't really, not that they don't matter, but it's not what's like super relevant at this point. Like what's super relevant is making sure you get the entire lit review and know what you're talking about and come up with a coherent design, rather than every single, you know, it was definitely like, what's it called? Looking at the trees instead of the forest or whatever. I was doing that. I was very specifically focused on like one tree and not seeing that there was an entire forest of stuff that I had to talk about. This also made it so that this was the first time in my life I've ever turned in things like right on time. Like we had a group project due at midnight. We turned it in at 11:56 p.m. I had a paper due at 9. I turned it in at like 8:30. Stuff also definitely took a lot more time than I realized, but definitely next time around, I'm gonna make sure to get like the bulk of it done. And if I have extra time, then I can perfect and refine the exact stimuli and the exact conditions, etc. So those are the five things that I learned my first semester of graduate school that I'm really excited to know now for the rest of my time as a student. I learned it's definitely a learning process, and I'm gonna mess up sometimes, I'm gonna mess up a lot, and as long as I'm doing better, learning something every day, applying the changes that I learn, then I'm on the right track. I don't need to compare myself to other people, especially people who are maybe from communications or already have their master's. My favorite quotes is, it's not fair to compare your beginning to someone else's middle. And I think that's very true in graduate school. Like, you don't know how much experience everyone else has had, right? So don't compare, realize that everything is a learning experience. So if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. Leave below in the comments any other tips you have for graduate students. Anyway, have a wonderful day. Keep dreaming out loud, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.